Maloila Maria Hoeki Lele Aitonga Kotoa. Welcome to this TP Plus special Talanoa. I'm John Pulu. And today's program, we're talking about the upcoming miniseries about All Blacks superstar Jonah Lomu that will air on Sunday and Monday this coming week here in New Zealand on TV3. Now, the two-part feature titled Jonah looks at the life and passing of the Tongan All Blacks legend. Here to discuss more is Halaifonua, who is a writer and training producer, and also Mosese Vea'ila, who plays Jonah. Maloilele.
Maloilele, John.
Now, before we continue our Talanoa, let's have a quick look at the trailer.
What do you want to achieve in the black jersey?
I want to be one of the greats. I want to win a World Cup. Score tries. Heaps of tries.
You're a gifted athlete, Jonah. A natural. Smashed every record we have.
Youngest All Black ever.
Yeah. Still can't wrap my head around it.
This is just the beginning.
His kidneys are piling up a bit.
How bad is it?
I've been pissing blood.
You think I'm finished?
It is done.
An unmissable three event.
I know what you're getting up to. You think I'm stupid?
Over two epic nights.
You have got something very special. You could go all the way.
Today, I'm prepared to die for this jersey.
Jonah, Sunday, August 18 and Monday, August 19 on 3.
Very nice. Well, boys, let's talk about the project. Halaifonua, tell me, how did it all start?
It's been a long process getting it to where we are now. I came in once kind of the early development had started by Carmen Leonard and Great Southern Television.
Cool, yeah.
So they're the ones that got the rights, and I came in when we started the interview process. So we interviewed, I think it was over 30 people, and that was about 12 months process of writing, interviewing to get to the script to a shooting stage, and then got to the auditions, and then we started shooting when? In March, was it?
Yeah,
March this year. So I was kind of, I think it was about 12 months prior of me starting in the writing process, and then we found this gem, diamond in the rough, and then we started shooting in March, and you know, it's kind of, they say, you know, have fun, time flies when you're having fun, so I can't believe it's actually coming to air now.
Yeah, of course, we're only days away from when it goes to air. You received some funding from New Zealand on air. How did you approach the story? Can you talk me through the process of gathering all the, you know, because he's a legend, he's a rugby legend. How did you go about putting that on the big screen?
I wasn't really part of that initial process, getting all the funding and stuff together, because I came in just as a training producer and writer. I came in as a writer first and then training producer, so I wasn't involved in that early initial phase. But I know that I think it was like a two-year process, really, of getting the family on board, and because it is such a big story. There was a lot of groundwork done before I was even brought on by Carmen and the team over at Great Southern to get it, because it's a story that needs to be told. And thankfully, I was part of it, because if I wasn't part of it, I would have been gutted.
Now, a lot of people know him as this big star, but what was your approach in terms of telling Jonah's story?
For me, because I grew up in the phase of Jonah coming up, like I was like 10, 11, 95 when he blew up. And before, and at that time, it was only like Michael Jones, Joe Stanley, it was only Samoans that were on TV that were famous. So I was like, oh, damn, man, where's the Tongans?
He was that
up?
One Tongan, eh?
Yeah, and then the biggest of them all was a Tongan. So coming up, it was awesome in my childhood growing up. And then when the opportunity to tell the story, it kind of came on the back of the MMT wave and Jason Tamalolo and Andrew Fifita. And so it was cool to go back and remind myself, but also another generation of young Tongans, and also reminding all Kiwis and stuff that this dude was huge, bigger than any of the stars that are around now. You know, he had a burger at McDonald's, his own shoe from Reebok.
That's like, when you know you made it.
PlayStation game, you know, it was all...
That's right.
It was all like stuff game. That we easily forget, kind of, because just time, so much time's gone past. So
he really did make a huge impact. Eh? I'll bring it over to you now, Moses. Now, Jonah was the youngest ever All Black when he debuted for the national team in 1994. I was just born. Just joking. He was only 19 years old. And Moses, you were about 21 and you played Jonah. What was it like for you? Tell me about the experience of, you know, playing this great rugby legend.
I think I was just... First of all, I was grateful that you know, the opportunity came my way.
Yeah.
But overall, I think it was just a learning experience here. Like every day coming onto set and meeting different people, getting to, you know, act beside, you know, Craig Hall and Kelson and all these like the people that I watched growing up.
Mm.
So everything just seemed quite like surreal.
Right.
Every day.
I understand you also attend the same church that Jonah's family.
Yeah, a lot of fun, yeah.
I think you were born to. What do you think, Halaifonua?
Oh man, our stars definitely aligned. Yeah, now my man was, you know, he's Māngere as well.
Māngere boy, yeah.
South same
Auckland.
Church.
You didn't go to Wesley, did you? Or?
No.
Māngere College,
MC,
head boy, man, as well.
So Māngere College. Yeah. Now, congratulations! You've recently graduated from the New Zealand Drama School. Can you talk me through how you prepared yourself for this role? Because you play the adult Jonah. There's some younger actors who play the younger version of Jonah Lomu. But how did you prepare yourself for this role?
I think mostly. Like the most challenging thing was just getting in shape, like, because Jonah was such a beast.
Yeah.
Just trying to cut down the carbs and work out.
Wow.
So we jammed with Jonah Fahu.
Yes.
He's Frank Buns, and he owns Ludus Magnus, which is a great place, and I jammed out there for a while, and then went with my man Nolo here. we worked together a lot. But not just with like the body stuff, but also just like spirit and mind, and trying to get more prepared for the role. And but yeah, I think those were definitely like the stuff that I was most concerned about.
Wow. Now, did you have to obviously you met with the family to do interviews so you can get the history correct? Can you talk me through that process, Halaifonua?
Yeah, it was good. It was actually quite surprising because when we interviewed Happy and John, John said that we were the first people that had interviewed them.
Wow.
From all of the kind of docos and stuff that had been made about Jonah that we interviewed them. So it was very lucky for me, and as well being able to speak Tongan, it was good to get Happy, so Happy was be able to explain herself as well. And John even came and visited us on set as well. That was the most important thing for me. Being the Tongan voice at the table was to make sure that it was authentic and it was true. And
family
it,
approval.
Yeah, got the tick of the family approval, man, because that was mainly it, because, you know, it was a small community, man, if that movie came out and we didn't get that tick.
And what were they like? I mean, you were bringing out something very personal to them, you know, their son.
Oh, it was a very privileged opportunity to be able to sit in the same house, you know, that they grew up in. And,
wow.
You know, to hear Happy and John's memories of Jonah growing up, candid memories, you know, some of the ones that we know more of, like Wesley College and, you know, the tough stuff of growing up out south. But also that was a good thing as well, hearing it from them is, you know, there was always this, like, message out there that Jonah grew up, like, rough and tough in South Auckland. But then hearing it from, you know, the horse's mouth, it was just like a normal Tongan upbringing that a lot of us have, you know. I prefer to call it more discipline than abuse, because, you know, we know when we've done wrong and our parents are just trying to do what's best for us.
Right.
So it was important for us to kind of get that side of Semisi across, because that's the narrative that's out there, is that he was a hard man on Jonah and Joseph Jackson on him, you know.
Right.
But really, he was just a dad that came from Tonga and wanted to give his kids the best opportunity and just showed them how he was taught. And it's the same with a lot of us, like Mo, me. It's funny because when we had to actually do the rehearsals for getting Tai, the younger actors, obviously growing up now, they didn't know how to react to getting Tai.
Discipline.
Yeah, so.
Street ha-has.
Yeah, so whereas I was like, have you never been hit by a Tau Whale? And they're like, nah. So it's good, you know, times are changing. times are changing.
Well, here's
know?
A little taster.
Yeah. Yeah.
Coming back to, can you tell me about the cast? I understand this is a very Tongan, it's a Tongan story, and also your co-cast members Tongan as well. Can you name some of them?
Yeah, so we had Cecilia and Michael Goloi, and they were playing Happy and Samisi.
Wow.
And we had Demetrius, who played one of the cousins who had passed away.
Oh.
And we had Dom Dubo, the man himself, playing young Jonah.
Yeah.
And yeah, we had
Lonnie.
Yeah, Sepp Lonnie, which is from Mangere. He's from Mangere as well.
Really?
Yeah. And I think he's in Mangere College too.
No, he's at Dilworth.
He's at Dilworth.
Oh, yeah. Flash
good man. Oh, good man.
Right. City school, right? Yeah, city school. Now, I know that Jonah played 63 tests, scoring 37 tries on the wing and retired in 2002. He was a great ambassador for the sport until his death from a heart attack in 2015 when he was aged 40. What was the most challenging part for you? I know that a lot of people know Jonah as this rugby legend, a hero, but he also had some health complications. What did you find challenging in terms of putting on his boots, so to speak?
I think there's the scenes where he really is sick, mm-hmm. and he really was very sick.
Yeah.
I remember when I was a kid, and you know how you do those little pukeloi's? And I was a master at that.
Right.
You know, just doing the street pukeloi.
Yeah.
But when I wanted to see if I could translate that into being Jonah, to see. But it was interesting to see that it's hard doing the pukeloi when you don't want to be puke.
Mm.
So being in that or don't want to be sick. So being that trying to be sick but not want to be sick was probably the hardest thing.
Yeah.
Just trying to balance those two things up.
Mm. Did you ever think that this is kind of your first role out of New Zealand Drama School? You're gonna play the one and only Jonah Lomu?
Nah, not at all. Mm. Not at all. I thought I was just gonna come back and straight. He's a butcher.
Now, what do you know? You're going to play Jonah.
Yeah.
But also, this is the second time Jonah Lomu has been portrayed on the big screen. Invictus was the other big film. But who do you think the story is for? Who would you like to watch this two-part series, Halaifonua?
For me, it's Tongans and Pacific Islanders. Because Jonah, what Jonah was, showed that one of us can reach those heights, you know? Whereas when we were kids growing up, our uncles and stuff and aunties and stuff like that, they all were in labouring jobs or, you know, we didn't see people doing those. It was either doctor or lawyer. That's what right. our family want. And to see Jonah get to those heights was amazing.
It's so too,
it's
right?
inspiring. So for the kids, the younger islanders, Pacific Islanders and Tongans especially, watching it, to see themselves on screen portraying a legend, you know, and guys like Mo, who's from Mangere, and hearing the Tongan language, our actors that are fluent in the language as well, and knowing as well that I'm behind the camera, that we can do, you know, greatness is in our DNA, you know, so just kind of, I want them to watch it, and also the rugby audience as well, because they'll probably be the harshest critics because, you know, a lot of the rugby fans would have read the books, watched the docos, everything, and be nitpicking. But I want them to watch it as well and be reminded also just how great this dude was, just how amazing he was, really. Yeah. That's it.
And you touched on it, but the fact that it's all Tongan cast, do you think, Mosese said that this is probably the beginning or maybe continuation of more Pacific stories
definitely.
That are going to be captured on the big screen?
Yeah, definitely.
What are your thoughts?
I think that's the wave, eh? I think the MMT, just with the league guys as well, I think we're slowly starting to see the rise of the horse.
Yeah. Literally speaking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You mentioned straight from the horse's mouth. This
yeah.
is a,
yeah.
this
yeah,
is a very Tongan discussion.
Yeah.
Stop horsing around.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But do you both think that, you know, this is going to be something to continue doing in the near future with more of our Pacific stories? We see the success of, you know, the recent Hobbs and Shaw movie with, you know, the Dwayne, my twin brother, and some of our, you know, Pacific actors in Moana. You know, do you think there's a real hunger for more Pacific stories?
I think a friend of mine, Jerry Taumiti, put it pretty awesome to me that Pacific stories are kind of like the final frontier in terms of film and television storytelling, because every other, you know, there's Asian stories, Native American stories, Western stories, African films, you know, European films, like the world knows all those stories, and the Pacific is kind of the last part of the world that hasn't been told yet. And like you said with Hobbs and Shaw, that's kind of opening up. But
For My Father's Kingdom.
For My Father's Kingdom.
The Herbs, you know, documentary. Yeah,
it's all coming out. All Jonah's coming projects. Out. And we've got, like, you know, there's some talent coming through, like Vea, Maifileo, Suli Moore's writing. He's coming theater. Up. Leckie Jackson Burke. And then even, you know, that Netflix series, Legend of Monkeys, got two Tongan leads in it, Josh Thompson and Luciani Buchanan. You know, so, and now Mo's in that. Like, you know, these are leading cast members that are Tongan. So it's just seeing more and more of our faces up there at that level too, you know. So it's just proof to the funders, to the general audience, that, you know, we deserve to be at that level.
Yeah. Any final words from you, Mosese, about Jonah and the series that that's going to air this weekend and also Monday?
I think for me, for like what the movie means to me is, like, I think the man deserves like justice to his story. And I think, I hope that when New Zealand sees, they can see that, you know, he was a true hero. He was a hero, you know, Toa in his time.
Just looking at he looks like Jonah in the early days, younger age.
Just got more hair.
You were born to be Jonah. And also, Halaifonua, if Jonah was here, what do you think he would say that you're obviously doing something about his life?
I think he'd probably be too shy. He probably wouldn't want us to do it. But talking to all of his friends and family and teammates, it gave us confidence that he would be proud of it, because we had a number of them come to set, and they... pretty much everyone that came to set cried when they saw Mo, because it brought back so much memories, and he did such an awesome job of transforming from Mosese to Jonah every day. So, you know, from his coaches, John Hart and stuff, that came on to set. Teammates, John Lomu came on, you know, they all found it quite hard being on set to see him. And so for us as like creative, seeing that kind of, even Nadine and the two boys came on set, and Braley is the oldest one, he's got a bit of a cameo in the film as which was a very special touch, you know, for us. So just with all of those people's kind of, just seeing how they responded and reacted, I just hope that that Jonah would have been proud of it as well, just as much as they were. And like, I'm proud of this dude, like, he's come a long way to transform himself from the Hupepe'e Mangere kid to a star.
He's the leading man.
Yeah. But I really do hope that we did Jonah proud, not only Jonah, but also Semisi, who's not with us anymore, and Happy, John, Sela, and Noah.
The family,
The family,
Well, Malo Obito boys, thank you very much, Halaifonua and Mosese, for the opportunity to talk more about this great rugby Tongan All Blacks legend, Jonah Lomu. Now, don't forget, you can catch it on TV3 this Sunday and coming Monday. So, Malo Obito, thank you very much.